Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we'll learn COBOL basic syntax. So this is the agenda. We'll learn character set, then coding area, followed by character strings, comment, literal and COBOL word. First we'll start with character set. So characters are the lowest in the hierarchy and they cannot be divided further. In the programming structure, in previous video, we have seen characters comes at the bottom. So it's the lowest in hierarchy. So the COBOL character set includes 78 characters which are shown below. So they are A to Z in upper case, as well as you can use A to Z in lower case. Then numbers you can use from 0 to 9, space, and these are some of like plus sign, minus sign, asterisk, comma, semicolon. So these are the valid character sets which can be used while doing COBOL programming. Now we'll start with coding area. So COBOL must be written in a format which is acceptable to a compiler. So COBOL programs are written in PDS members which are declared with a record length of 80 bytes because compiler understands only 80 bytes. So we have 80 characters that are present in coding area. Now we'll see how they are divided. So column number 1 to 6, they are reserved for line numbers. So you do not need to change them, they come automatically. Then we have 7th as an indicator. Here you can give asterisk. If you mention asterisk, that line will become a comment line. And if you mention hyphen, it indicates continuation, like it is, we are continuing the previous line. And then we have slash, it is indicated form feed. Further, we have area A and area B in which we do all our coding. So area A starts from 8 to 11, column number 8 to 11, and all the COBOL divisions, sections, paragraphs, and some special entries must begin in area A. Then we have area B that starts from 12 to 72. All the COBOL statements must begin in this area. So then the identification area 73 to 80. So it can be used as needed by the programmer, but normally we do not use this area. So we code from area A in and area B, and we use 7 for commenting out the line. Now we have character strings. In COBOL, when you declare user defined words or when you want to declare a comment line, then we use character strings. So a character string must end with separators. Now what is separators? A separator is used to separate the character strings. So they can be spaces, they can be comma, they can be period, apostrophe, left, right, parenthesis and quotation mark. So a character string can be comment, as we have discussed, like if you put a comment line, you can, a character string can be used as a comment or it can be used as a literal, like when you declare the values in the working storage area. Suppose you have declared one variable and you want to assign some value to that variable, then that is known as literal. And then COBOL words. So COBOL words, like when we declare the paragraphs, we use COBOL words, we declare them. So these are the use of character strings. Now let's see all these functions practically.
We have seen the character set. COBOL character sets include 78 characters. Now we'll see the coding area. Member list. We'll open first basic syntax, then reset. The source program of COBOL must be written in a format that is acceptable to the compiler. COBOL programs are written in COBOL coding sheets. There are 80 characters positioned on each line of a coding sheet. Now that is further divided into 5 fields. We will write COLS to make it clear. Columns. Then press F10 to see the leftmost 6 characters. As you can see, it is starting from 7th character. And here also you can see this is 7th, 8th, 9th and this is 10th. So I will press F10. First 6, you can see this is 1st and this is 6th. They are the column numbers. They are basically reserved for line numbers. We do not use them while coding. They are automatically populated. Then on the 7th, this is 7th character, we have an indicator. If we have an asterisk, so it indicates comment. These all are comment line. If we indicate hyphen, suppose if I indicate hyphen here, it means it is indicating continuation. I will change it again because we are not showing any continuation here. And if you mention slash, that indicates a form feed. So this slash. It indicates a form field. I will change it again to asterisk. From position number 8th, here you can see this is position number 8th, 9th, 10th and 11th. This is our area A. 8 to 11 we have area A, all the COBOL divisions, sections, paragraphs and some special entries must begin in this area only. If you code them in area B, you will get a compilation error. Now we have area B. Area B starts from this point. So this is 12th position and it is up to 72. I will press F11. Here I'm pressing F11 one more time. This is 72 position. Area B starts from 12 and it is still 72 and all the COBOL statements must begin in this area. And in the end we have 73 to 80 which is identification area, and it can be used as needed by the programmer. Generally we don't use them. I'm pressing F10. I'm exiting it just to get into the normal format. It is more readable. Now we have character strings. Character strings are formed by combining individual characters. A character string can be a comment, it can be a literal, or it can be a COBOL word. We'll start with comment. A comment is a character string that does not affect the execution of a program. It can be any combination of characters. So we have a comment line. This is a comment line. As mentioned, if we mention asterisk at 7th position, the line becomes a comment line. This is a comment line. Then we have a comment entry. Comment entries are those that are included in the optional paragraph of identification division. Here, tutorials point is an comment entry. So this is an optional paragraph of identification division. We used to write them in area B and programmers use it for reference. This is comment entry. Then we have literals. Literal is a constant that is directly hard-coded in the program. Here you can see hello world. This is a literal. We have two type of literals. One is alphanumeric literal and one is numerical literal. Alphanumeric literals are enclosed in quotes or apostrophe. Length can be up to maximum 160 characters. An apostrophe or a quote can be a part of a literal only if it is paired. So what does that mean? Here, this is a literal. This is not invalid. It means this is valid, but we cannot mention apostrophe here. If you want to mention apostrophe, then it should be in pair. When we'll print this, only this thing will come. This is one single apostrophe and then invalid. Starting and ending of a literal should be same. Either it should be apostrophe, either it should be a quote. So this is a valid one. Display hello world. This is alphanumeric literal. Then this is also a valid one. This is not invalid. So this is a valid one because we have paired this apostrophe. Then we have this is invalid. Why this is invalid? Because we have started with single quote and here you can see it ended with a double quote. So it should be same. Program will throw an error for this. Then we have numeric literals. Numeric literal is a combination of digits from 0 to 9, plus sign, minus sign, or a decimal point. Length can be up to 18 characters. Sign cannot be the rightmost character, and decimal point should not appear at the end. So we'll see the valid scenarios and invalid scenarios. Here, this is numeric literal. We have given value 100. This is a valid one. So we can write 100 or we can write plus 10.79 or any value. Like sign should be in the leftmost character. Similarly for minus as well. It should be in the leftmost character. Here sign should be in the leftmost, not the rightmost. Then we have invalid ones. If you mention 1000 as 1,000, this is invalid. This is not acceptable by the compiler. Then decimal cannot be at the rightmost position. Similarly, sign cannot be at the rightmost position. Then we have COBOL words. COBOL word is a character string that can be reserved word or a user defined word. Its length can be up to 30 characters. We have two type of COBOL words. One is user defined. Here this WS class, this is user defined COBOL word. User defined words are used for naming files, data, records, paragraph names and sections. Alphabets, digits and hyphens are allowed while forming the user defined one. We cannot use COBOL reserved words for user defined words. Here I cannot write add, subtract because they are reserved words. Reserved words are of three types: keywords like add, except, move, subtract, multiply, then special characters plus, minus, multiply, equal to, and then we have figurative constant. Zeros, high values, low values, spaces, quotes, and all literals. Zeros, you understand? High values are one or more characters which will be at the highest position in the descending order. And for low values, one or more characters that have zero in the binary representation. Then we have spaces, quotes, or all literal. So these are different type of figurative constants. So this is all about basic syntax. We have covered coding area and we have seen the COBOL words, comment line, comment entry, literals, reserved words. So in the next video, we'll cover the data types.